This portion of Sandy and Friends is brought to you in part by Earnhardt Liberty Kia in Prescott Valley. No bull since 1951.
So, the Humane Society, a place where you save pets and you can save yourself. Let's find out how. Terri Davis, great to have you on again.
Hey, good morning. Thanks for having us.
So this is kind of neat. We've talked about this a little bit because I know when I walk my dog, I'm thinking, you're saving my life because otherwise I would not be out in this rain or whatever.
It's so true. They do so much for us. You know, last week we talked about resolutions and how having a pet makes us more healthy. Mm-hmm. So I started thinking about what about people that don't have pets? How can they contribute and how can they be healthy through animals?
Oh, great idea.
Yeah, so I wanted to invite your viewers to volunteer with us. To help with their resolutions. So I know a lot of us have maybe spending more time with our family as a resolution, mm-hmm. and you can bring the whole family down to YHS, and you can volunteer walking dogs, or you can volunteer cuddling cats, maybe your family's crafters. And so we have some great ideas on how to make dog toys and cat toys on our website. If you go to yavapaihumane.org, so as a family, you can make some toys for homeless pets, which is a great time to spend more time with the family.
And a great education for kids, too, because, you know, compassion for animals translates into compassion for people as well.
It absolutely does. You know, they might not remember going to a movie, but they're really going to remember helping homeless pets with their mom and dad. So it's a great way to spend more time.
That is a good idea. Wow. And then we talked about exercise.
Yes.
Of course, you know, so how about if you don't have a dog, how do you get that benefit with pets?
Go to your local shelter. They need people to walk pets, to walk their dogs. We're lucky we have an equine rescue, so you can also get some exercise by helping feed our horses or walking them around the arena. So that's another great
way. Can you ride the horses?
You can, once you go through our training process.
Wow!
Yeah.
Okay, I did not know that. I'm excited about that.
So we're basically rehoming horses, and so we want to make them adoptable.
Very socialized and everything.
Exactly, is to make sure that they've been ridden and that they're friendly with people, so you can volunteer out there and do that.
Oh, that is the coolest thing ever.
Lots
okay, did you mention something about crafts, like redecorating or something?
Yes.
I mean, what is this?
You know, my New Year's resolution is to spend less money, but I also need to redecorate my guest room. And so the thrift store is a great way to volunteer.
Oh, yes.
Yes, if you're volunteering there, you get to see stuff before it hits the floor. So, you know, my grandma would be proud. She's a big thrifter, and I go over there and volunteer, and maybe I'll see that beautiful recliner or that one-of-a-kind marble table before it hits the floor, and I'll get to purchase that, and that, again, goes back to helping the pets at the shelter.
No, you're going to laugh, but literally, my husband said we were going down an alley, and there was this beautiful cherry cabinet, and he said, oh, my gosh, we have got to take that. I said, we don't need that. He said, no, but if someone just picks it up, then it doesn't benefit only them. But if we take it to the thrift store, it benefits the animals, too.
I love it.
You know, I thought that was pretty creative.
That's fantastic. Absolutely. You know, we always make sure that everything's working before we put it on our floor. So, you know, we would double check it out before we put it out there. But absolutely, if it's in good shape, please bring it to help our
pets. It's beautiful. The things you have, whether it's clothes or things for the animals or kitchen stuff, I mean, china, you name it, furniture, beautiful stuff at the Humane Society. We'll talk more about that. But we have an interesting guest this morning. We're always happy when Margie brings us a dog. And Jaden is with us. Look at this. Is the most handsome dog.
Isn't he
beautiful?
Tell
us about Jaden.
So Jaden is a 6-year-old Siberian Husky. He came from a home with a mom and dad and kiddos. So he loves kids. He loves people. He's a little picky when it comes to treats. So, you know, he won't just take any treat. He wants the high quality stuff.
It's like my family pets are like,
right?
What? That same old stuff?
Exactly. I'm like that with chocolate. If you give me sugar, I don't want it. But if it's chocolate, I'll take it. So
yeah.
I get
everybody
where Jaden's coming
from. Everybody has their taste. Yes. We're all pretty much alike. We mammals. Well, I tell you, he is absolutely stunning.
He is.
Oh, he said hi to us,
too. That's the first time I've heard him talk all morning, so that's different.
Good. Yes, and, you know, he's very, very friendly to all of us, and it's crazy to rate at a TV station because there's all kinds of people, new people,
yes.
and he was just marvelous this morning,
He's
too.
Loving every minute of being here, so
right.
Thanks to your crew for giving him some extra love.
And he's well-trained, or what do we know? What else do
we
know
about Jay? He knows a few commands. He could stand to learn a few more, but he knows the basics. He knows sit and lay down and the basic commands.
And he just showed us the sit command for a treat.
Showing
off. Oh, you know, and those blue eyes, who wouldn't fall in love with those
yes.
blue eyes?
He's really looking for a family. So if you have kids and you're looking for a well-rounded dog, Jaden's your guy.
I think Chris Dobrowolski might take Jaden.
There you go. Call me.
Okay.
I can make a call.
Yeah. Let's talk to you
soon. I have the hookup.
Absolutely gorgeous. Well, that and many more animals over at the Humane Society. So get on over there, cats, dogs, horses, mules, sometimes rabbits, you never know.
You never know.
Terri Davis, thanks for joining us. And Jaden and Margie as well.
Thank you.